Now we're going to discuss chapter 4, inverse trigonometry, ITF. Okay, topic covered over here is differential and integration of inverse trigonometry function. So, okay, so if you see over here, okay, so if you have cos, okay, the graph of cos, okay, then the inverse of it, it will be, okay, reflecting towards y equals to x axis, okay. So the objective of this chapter, you will be able to solve the inverse trigonometry function by using the formula, differentiate expression, and then integrate expression involving the inverse trigonometry functions. Okay, so before that, let us look at one of the real life application. Okay, the inverse trigonometry function are used to determine the angle measured when at least two sides of a right angle are known. Okay, so contrary to our trigonometry function, that is you being provided to, and then you try to find, you've been given the angle and one of the length. So what you need to do is, so you use the angle and then you use one of the length to find the rest of the length. Okay, so one, for example, that is here, the building is on fire, so firemen are coming to rescue the people who are trapped in the tall building. So what angle do you need to lay the ladder to reach the window? So let's say that we have the angle, this is the tall building, okay, and then it's let's say it's a 70 meter high, and then the length from the which is the safe, the safest path, okay, from the building will be, let's say it's about 20 meter. So then you can use like tangent theta. We know that tangent theta is a opposite of a adjacent. So then let's say you have a, then you want to find the theta, then you can use tangent inverse of the 70 over 20. Okay, then the second one is the zebra Daniel. Okay, so this fish actually is a small tropical fish. Okay, so in a reality, that is a small fish is always being eaten by the larger fish. Okay, so what happened? So cannot be that is this fish, they need to avoid the bigger fish, but they cannot be keep on avoiding while they also need to finding their own food. Okay, but this special fish, that is, they have a mechanism. Okay, when they see, okay, when they see the predator in front of them, for certain, they already can notice it's like how many meters, automatically they would be turning, okay, they'll be turning how many degree, try to avoid the predator to attack them directly. Okay, so this is the special mechanism which this zebra Daniel have. Okay, so now, okay, so for you, that is, if you want to master for chapter 4, then you need to know that is in differentiation, we have three different methods. The first one is chain rules, the second one is product rules, the third one is quotient rules. And then in the integration, okay, because of our syllabus that you have not learning much of the methods, but the thing is, over here we have two that we always can use for this chapter. The first one will be integration by parts, then the second one is integration by using substitutions, and then as you know that integration, then we have then another one is called definite integration. They have no difference with the normal integration. The only thing that is you by the end of the solution that you need to substitute the respective limit into the integration. Okay, so let us look at what is a inverse trigonometry function. Are simply defined as the inverse function of the basic trigonometry, which are sine, cotangent, cotangent, secant, and cosecant. Okay, so remember over here is inverse, it's not 1/1. So normally we will write as sine, that is a minus 1x, or some people they will pronounce or they will write as an arc sine. Okay, why that is in this the terms of arc? Actually, because of this thing is an arch. Okay, this is an arch, so then they call it as an inverse, so that is a called arc sine. Okay, so remember here, this is 1/sine x, or if you notice that these two are totally different writing. That is sine inverse means that your sine, there is a minus 1 here, is inverse. This one is sine, at the last we have a minus 1. Okay, please don't confuse with our sine x square. Then normally we write as a sine square x. Yes, it's true, but the thing is, in this context, when we are involving the inverse, so that please differentiate, these two are not equal. Okay, and then over here is saying that is for y equals to sine inverse x, is only if and only if your x is in the negative 1 and 1, and your y is in negative pi over 2 until pi over 2 and sine 1 and so on. Okay, now, why they have this condition? That is, if you look at our sine graph, okay, it is a wave curve. Okay, but the thing is, during max 1, you learn that is a function which has an inverse if it is 1-to-1 function. Okay, so basically sine x actually is 1. Okay, it is a 1-to-many. Okay, is it 1-to-many or okay, many to one? Okay, why it is called many to one? Because if you see, that is, we have two different values going to the same value here, so that means it is called many to one. Okay, so now if we want to make sure our sine, which has an inverse, so that we have to limit its domain, so when we cut our sine in this way, so then over this, from a negative pi over 2 until pi over 2, our graph is 1-to-1. You can test by using vertical and horizontal line tests. Okay, so now look at the first one. We try to force our trigonometry function to become 1-to-1 function. So okay, if over here, how you want to force it, then we can cut them into, okay, the lowest limit and highest limit. Okay, if you look at the sine, okay, why we cut from negative pi over 2 until pi over 2? Because it covers from negative 1 to 1. Okay, then how about our cos? Cos over here, if you want to cover from negative 1 to 1, that is the best one, actually is from 0 until pi. Oh, sorry, is 0 until pi. After that, for our tangent, okay, our tangent, don't forget this pi over 2, their asymptote. Okay, so you have no other choice, so definitely you are going to have a limitation from negative pi over 2 until pi over 2. And then our cot, okay, so the coset, okay, coset also these two. Then for second is these two, and then cotangent is these two. Okay, so basically, okay, for the sine, they to make sure restriction domain for the, to make sure it is 1-to-1, so this one is the domain, and then the other of the range. Okay, so now, because of you want to find, okay, the graph of the sine inverse, okay, so we know that is when we have a function, we which is 1-to-1, and if you have the inverse of it, that is, it going to reflect, okay, it going to reflect at y equals to x. Okay, so this blue, okay, this blue line, okay, is the our y equals to sine x. Okay, it's going to reflect x, y equals to x, so that's why we have the reflection graph of the red color, so that is y equals to sine inverse x. How about the rest of it? Because the rest of it is not in our domain of one-to-one function, so you are not going to do the reflection of others. Okay. Then how about our beloved cos x? Okay, cos is from 0 to pi. Okay, this one is a little bit. Okay, so if you see that this is y equals to x, how you want to sketch? So you try to flip. Okay, so you try to flip. So this blue is going to reflect at this red, and then this blue is going to reflect as this red. So one way to get it is maybe you can use your paper and then you try to fold and you try to trace, so then you can easily can find the sketch the graph of cos inverse. Okay, and if you notice that is okay for our cos x, okay, we are using theta, okay, but for the cos inverse they are using the number of the x-axis, because remember when we have a function domain to the range, okay, when we have a f inverse, our range will become our domain and then the domain will become our range. Okay, then this is how our tangent look like. Okay, the blue one is the tangent and then the red one is the tangent inverse, and this is the chord. Okay, and then we have our cosecant and then our secant. Okay, so basically these are the six type of the normal inverse trigonometry function that we have.